All right, it's 11 a.m. We gotta get up.
It's not just another day. It's another day to excel.
Another day to be great. Rise and shine.
It's not just another day. It's another day to excel.
Everybody get up singing. Fire will make you get down, yeah. I need to package Hogs of War, the sealed PS1 game that I sold last night for £49.99 plus £3.50 postage. But first of all, coffee. Oh God.
What?
Hi. Yeah, so this is me literally every morning, some ready break with some peanut butter mixed in and a coffee, of course.
Why I hold it like that? It's the law. It's just comfy.
Okay, let's get back to home screen. What are we going to watch? What are we going to watch this morning while we are having breakfast? Two Aussie Thrifters. I haven't watched them before. I've been meaning to check them out since I saw them on Global Thrifters videos before. Ali A, are you really invested in COD though? Because, you know, you're still doing Fortnite, man. Oh, I don't know. Syndicate. Oh, I've not seen this one. Episode 418 is what he's up to, man. 800 a week part-time again. Go on, James. Let's dive in.
Oh, I've just realised I spilt spag bol on my bed last night.
So as I'm getting this all set up to be tested, enjoy some footage of me singing ABBA on the Wii as I was testing Wii equipment. So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? SOS.
Yeah, it's working. I'm testing it. The love you gave me, nothing else can save me.
And after that performance, I decided I'm going to keep it. No, seriously, I've kept it.
Oh, you don't believe me! You guys don't believe me, do you?
There you go. I am damn well keeping it. So, yeah, I honestly, you can see how much I enjoyed that. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to playing that with the missus after lockdown. That'll be fun. Also, within some Wii bundles that I picked up, a couple of things were keepers. So I did have one of these, but the rubbery bits on the analog sticks were just a bit frayed and a little bit damaged. They had the defects, but this one's in awesome condition. And I absolutely love this little Wii controller. So, yeah, this one is a keeper for the collection. And also a really nice sealed game, Dead Space Extraction. I don't know if this would be worth anything on eBay. I'll give it a quick search because it is sealed. But I don't have this for the collection, so it would end up getting opened and played at some point. But I'll check value first just to see if there's anything in it.
Right, let me try and remember because I'm going to forget this already. So there's one that has sold on the 11th. I think today is the 20th. I'm losing track of the days. These are both this month. Sold on the 11th for £12, and there's one that sold on the 18th. I think it was £17 plus £1.64 postage. So I think, as nice as it is having a game from sealed and being the only person opening it and owning it, and the stickers on it as well, which is really nice, got an 8 out of 10 from Edge. Sorry, it's reversed. Yeah, I think it might be worth sticking on the bay, you know. and I can always pick it up at another time from CEX with credit. Yeah, sealed games, as you can see, because I sold the sealed Hogs of War. They really don't appeal to me because I'm a player. I like to actually play the games. I don't keep sealed. I'd rather flog them and take advantage of the value in them.
So that was the sticker, so you can see it properly. So yeah, it's a nice Brucey bonus that the stickers are on there. That's actually on the case. I didn't know if that was a sticker, but yeah.
Yeah, easy as that. On the bay it goes. I have been quite strict on my collection, believe it or not. I do pick at things now and again. There's nothing else I can really... I'll have a little look. I've been like trying to slim the collection down, believe it or not. That is something I cannot currently get a value of at the moment. There's none on eBay. I picked it up for £10. I got that pre-lockdown from Facebook Marketplace. Yeah, they did it for 15 quid. Asked if it was available. And I was thinking about it. And then the next day they'd loaded it to a tenner. And I was like, oh, it's a no-brainer really. I've got to go get it. All the contents are sealed, by the way. And it's all fully working. I've tested it. Because I got it all set up to go onto eBay. And then I was a bit reluctant to sell it. But what's holding me back is that I just don't know the value. I want to try and get top dollar for it. Because it's a bit of a reluctant sale. Because I would love to keep it. But I can't be hoarding things I've got to sell. But I want to get the best price that I can for it.
All tested, sorted and ready for listing. Unfortunately, there is a mark on it. You should have seen it before. It was like a really bad, like a leaked biro mark. But I had a little go, but my mum also worked her wonders on it, and that's the best we're gonna get, like Gillette. So it's not looking too bad now. Just a, like I say, just my little defect. And plus the one of the panels is missing, unfortunately. So I don't know why or how do these go missing, seriously. But anyway, this is a bit of a lad's bundle. It's not the best at all, but them two are all right games. So yeah, we'll see how we go with that. List it on eBay. So I've basically got a bath all run, and while that's cooling down a little bit, the sealed Hogs of War. I've actually not sent a sealed game before. Proper making sure with packages well. And I've actually done a video before. I'm so scared. So yeah, I've basically done a video to show that like the disc is not loose in there. You can see it. It's like a blue disc and it's like resting on the video I did anyway. I could include it in this anyway. Yeah, the disc is like just resting, you know, obviously as it would. And then the only kind of noise you'll hear, if you can hear that faintly, it's literally just the manual moving about. So yeah, I've got several layers of bubble wrap there. And yeah, I'm just going to try and pad it out a little bit both sides. So make sure we try get it in really nice and secure. Obviously got a coffee on standby as well. I feel like I might put it in like diagonally and just get a couple more bits of foam or something at each side, and then we should be all good. It's got to be really careful and sensible and really pad this out. Cut a little strip of bubble wrap off. I'm very cautious. I mean, over cautious as well. Like, it's just because it's a bit of a pricey item, that's all. But yeah, it'll seal up really nicely, be all nice and secure. I just haven't written the label on it. There's no other outstanding parcels that are currently waiting to go out at the moment, so I know obviously what's in there. But yeah, I've got some Sharpie permanent markers arriving tomorrow, so I don't want to write in normal biro. I want to wait till I've got my Sharpies.
Huge!
That is huge!
That is literally right up to the ceiling.
That's so cool, I love it. You say next door's got the Santa as well?
Right. Sorry guys, I need to straighten my hair. Yeah, I've just had to do like a really cringy post on GGG on the Game Gear group, because you can get absolutely roasted on there. So yeah, I've kind of took the piss out of myself already on my post, because I've basically, I think Papa John's is going to be on the cards again. So if you watched the first vlog, I ordered a Papa John's because every time you order the Call of Duty bundle, which is an online deal only, you get a code for an in-game item, one of three. So to get all three items, you have to place three orders, get three codes basically. And also with an in-game code, you get a code for the double XP. I've not yet used mine. But anyway, I placed that order. So I've already got a special edition like calling card. So I need another code to get me the emblem, and then a third code will get me the weapon charm. So the reason I've asked on the group, I just said, you know, I know I sound like a massive virgin, but if anyone has any spare Papa John's Call of Duty bundle codes, please could you kindly send them my way, because I want the emblem and the weapon charm now. So yeah, I took the piss out of myself on the post before anyone else can say it first. So yeah, it's looking like I'm going to place a Papa John's order tonight, and then that will get me the emblem. Crucially, I really want that weapon charm as well, man. So yeah, it just really helped. It's just I don't know how long the offer's on for, so obviously I don't want the offer to like end and then I can't, you know, then get the other item. So it'd just be really nice to get all three, so I'm just kind of going for it.
This will be the thumbnail for this vlog, which you'll have seen already. It's totally going to be an ABBA one because of the previous clips that you've just seen.
Number 7. As if I've got to 7, it's mad.
There we go, guys. Just entered the second code. Yes, I've just ordered a Papa John's. Because I do want pizza as well. You know, I'm just more inclined because I want the items. So, yeah, I've just unlocked the emblem. So next, it is the weapon charm. Hopefully I can place another order in some night soon before this offer ends. Yeah, I just don't know how long this offer is on for. Just redeemed the other code as well. This is for double XP. I've not even activated my fair slot yet. I can't remember how to be honest. I did see an option for it, but it was like really late at night and I thought, oh, I don't feel like I'm at my best. Like I can get like the optimum, you know, amount of kills and everything. But no, I will activate it tonight, to be fair, and we'll smash some COD out. So yeah, that is the second code. Gained, I've accumulated 60 minutes of double XP so far. So Papa John's is here. That was a very speedy delivery. Yeah, again, for the second time. They didn't have any sugar-free Mountain Dew. I really fancied a Mountain Dew, man. It's like, sort it out. So they gave me a big thing of 7-Up, but I'm not that into it, to be fair. Phil's into it, so I might wrap it up for him for Christmas. For the banter. But yeah, I'm going to enjoy this. I've got some sugar-free Monsters anyway. I had a multi-pack down there, so that is going to go my takeaway. And I'm going to watch some eBay YouTubers resellers. That came out weird. I don't know, eBay resellers / YouTubers. So it is late again, late-ish. I think it's pushing on around 11 o'clock right now. So I've watched me telly for tonight. I've watched I'm a Celeb and then I've watched Gogglebox. It was both on at the same time, so I watched Gogglebox after. So I just watched it downstairs with my mum and stepdad because they basically twisted my arm and got me to pour them a JD honey and Pepsi because I was having one. So I got roped into that. So I thought I'd be social, watch Gogglebox with them. When they have the remote, it's literally, you know when they're going to put it on, because it's in recordings, they're literally like, oh, hang on, my cup's in the way, the thing's like I'm doing an impression, hang on. Yeah, they literally go like, it is literally so suspenseful as they take so long again to press right again, to select Gogglebox, to press play. It's like, oh man, it takes ages.
I'm so sorry if any of you do this. It's literally all fun, bit of banter. So what have I done? A few things to show you before I head off. So yeah, I've sprayed a bit of my Lady Million. I love Paco Rabanne Lady Million. I like just wearing it when I'm chilling out. So I just wanted to smell good while I'm gaming.
Picking at things. I like to pick at my collection and things. Looking for some more things to list on eBay. So Pokemon cards, I mean, where do I start? There's lots stacked up on there. They're all like newer ones because I love collecting the retro. I've got no interest really in like the newer sets, but yeah, these are from the Fates Collide sets and these are holos and reverse holos, but they're literally not worth anything. And I looked at even bundles of them, but it still does not look like I can kind of get anything from them. I don't know. I'm going to have to kind of research this a bit more, but I don't know. I feel really stuck with these at the moment. I thought I'll start with this set, see how we get on with that. But I feel really stuck with them in all honesty, guys.
Oh, you are shitting me. Why? Every time I just want to sit down and play the game. Well, that's cut out the window until that update's done.
I'll have to jump back on Assassin's Creed Valhalla and see if they've patched that like massive glitch that stops me from progressing and invading as Vikings in the game. So when I was picking around hunting around some eBay items, so yeah, I stumbled across this lot. So firstly, I got this from the car, but it was literally like 25p. Unlucky for me, didn't have a game in, but it had Manuel in. No hang tab on it. Original Sega sticker on the spine, which is nice. And, well,
the other side of the spine.
You really call it the spine.
But anyway, yeah, it's still got the sticker on as well, that saying about the limited edition 6-track music CD. However, that was not included. It's literally so expensive to buy on its own. I've seen them on eBay for like 60, 70 quid just for the CD. So yeah, I've had no luck in sourcing a CD. I could, you know, look for a car only, but at the minute, I don't feel like it's a priority. I'm going to see how much I reckon I could get for this. So I'm going to eBay it. Well, search it on eBay anyway. See if it's worth parting with for some dollar. Also got this Hanna-Barbera DVD box set from the car boot. I think I got it for like £2 or something. However, one of the DVDs, it's not the right one. So the one that's missing from this is the Flintstones Volume 1. And there's an extra Wacky Races in there that's not meant to be in there. Wacky Races Volume 3. So that is in there in place of the Flintstones. So it's not actually the full-on complete set. Obviously, Flintstones should be there. And we've got Volume 3. But still, it's an awesome box set. I've seen it go for around like 15 to 20 quid. Well, even like around the 20 quid plus, really, on most of them. So, yeah, I think I'm going to put it for £14.99. Obviously, just state what's up with it and see how we go with that. I know it's not how it's meant to be, obviously, but it's still a decent box set. So some of the games I've picked out, some modern games actually, well, more modern. Yeah, I've never really thought about parting with any of my Xbox One games, but they're just ones that, like, I just literally don't play, and I've got no plans in playing, or I've already completed them. So I reckon I could just fetch a few quid off these on eBay, I reckon. I tried that. I was on one of the first missions. I literally couldn't get past it. It was just ridiculous. I loved Just Cause 2. I thought that was atrocious, to be honest. I don't know if any of you guys got on with it all right, but I'm looking to part with that. These games, literally, I think that I've had a look at most of them. They literally only go for like a few quid on eBay. Oh, that's not meant to be in there. So that's my day one edition. No, I'll keep that. but yeah, they only literally go for like a few quid, but I think I'm going to bundle some together. And yeah, then it'll be kind of worth it. Because if I do them singularly, that's a bit of a weird word to say, singularly, then it'll just be like a few quid, and then it'll be messing about with postage. But if they're doing like bundles, it's not too bad. The Crew, I've never even bothered with that. It looked a decent game, but like I say, it's like online only and all that shite. I like me offline games, single player and whatever. Picked this up from the car boot at some point. It was only like a quid. The Escapist Walking Dead Edition. You get £3 trade at CX. So worst case scenario, I'd end up trading. Yeah, so I just thought, I've got no plans to play that. The Walking Dead's proper gone down the pan. It literally did since like season 2, season 3. It was just awful. And what else have I got? Zombie. Yeah, Holster, what are you doing selling a zombie game? I don't think it really looks that good. It's not meant to be very good. But again, I shouldn't prejudge. I should have a go of it, really. But yeah, I believe that's just a few quid trade at CEX. I might bundle that, maybe do a zombie bundle there. Evil Within 1 and 2, I did enjoy that one. It was a decent game, it was alright. Really didn't enjoy the second one. I did kind of in parts. I enjoyed, you know, the kind of survival horror elements of it, but most of the time it was just really annoying. I found the enemies, and especially the bosses, really annoying and tedious. I enjoyed that one more, but like I said, I've got no plans to revisit these two because I didn't have that much fun. I had more fun with the first one rather than the second, but I'll see how much I could get possibly bundling them two together. But for now, guys, it's almost midnight and I'm totally going to shut off now. I've got a cheeky JD, honey and Pepsi, and I'm going to do some gaming. So until the next vlog, take care, guys. See you in the next one.